Just a few days to the reopening of schools on the new academic year, the Vision Group has organized the first ever education expo in the country. The expo has been designed as a one-stop center for anything to do with education. It brings together players in the education sector to showcase the latest products and services, as well as interventions designed to counter the various challenges in the education sector. Bills explains that there will be training workshops with experts discussing different topics such as early childhood development, parenting, career guidance, and most importantly, the ongoing curriculum reforms.
We are simply focusing on providing a convergence point for all key stakeholders in Uganda and in the region and globally to come together and play a role in rejuvenating the sector that was badly affected by the COVID pandemic.
At the venue, it is a beehive of activities as various exhibitors set up their stalls in preparation for tomorrow. These explained the services they will offer to those who will turn up for the expo.
We're here at the Education Expo at UICT grounds, ready to exhibit what we are better at doing, and that is bringing more of an innovative world concerning education in this globe. We are here to showcase most of our programs which lie in business, IT, engineering, and health sciences. We welcome you all to come and visit us right here at the Education Expo because there's plenty to learn from our side.
Today we shall be showcasing the Active Learning Project, which basically focuses on teacher education and training. And we shall be offering services on teacher capacity development workshops related to active learning pedagogical practices. So people are going to be coming through here, just so you know, we're going to know more about our services. We do on-site training services where we can come to your school or your setting and be able to provide these trainings. We also partner with actually government and train teacher educators and teacher trainees in these practices. And the active learning practices are basically around 21st century pedagogical practices, which focus on critical thinking, creative thinking, and ethical practices.
And we've come to partner with New Vision to be as exhibitors, to help our parents be able to return their kids to school. We know the economy is not doing well, and parents are struggling to look for money. We have different products, inclusive of school fees, and we shall be engaging our parents and guardians about how they can get this school fees loan so that they are able to take their kids back to school.
Edward Mugabe, a Ugandan author, believes the expo will be a great opportunity to equip Ugandans with a reading culture.
Most of the developing countries have a high reading skills, and they've been able to achieve that for centuries. You know, most of us have read books that were written, you know, in the 18th, 17th centuries, what we call the classics, the Shakespeare's and so on. You know, that culture, you know, has been developed from literature to business to innovations to development, you know.
Tomorrow, the Minister of Education and Sports will be releasing the primary leaving examinations. At the expo, a special tent has been put up to celebrate those that have excelled in the exams. Meanwhile, Kato Semakula Senkebe from Aristoc Booklegs Limited, one of the sponsors of the New Vision Education Expo, explains why they decided to partner with the Vision Group to organize this expo.
Look, in the 30 years we've been open, we're very passionate about books. We're very passionate about Ugandans having a reading culture. So when New Vision took this opportunity to create an expo, we said this is something that we have to attach ourselves to and be a part of. We vehemently support it, and we endorse the action behind treating Ugandans as sponges for information and knowledge.
The expo is under the theme Where Education and the World of Employment Meet. Entrance to the venue will be 10,000 shillings only, but all activities will be free of charge. Rachel Nachuala reporting for the news.